Say hey, Yellow Jacket football fans. Welcome to the Coach Hal Lamb Show. And Coach, congratulations on a 55-7 victory, and congratulations on a surefire 15th consecutive region championship and your 15th consecutive year with double-digit victories in a season.
Thanks, Dave. You know, it was a credit to, obviously, our seniors.
Yes.
Tonight was their senior night, or last night was their senior night. And real pleased that a lot of those kids got a lot of playing time last night. And real pleased the turnout we had for senior night with the weather.
Yes.
You know, as shaky as it was, I thought we had a decent crowd. And happy for those 29 seniors for sure.
They got a lot of playing time. It was a big way to end the regular season. There's going to be more games at the Reeve, obviously, but it's a nice way to go out as far as ending the regular season. I talked to several guys in the hallway, and I said, you're going to get a lot of snaps tonight, and congratulations to you. You got those guys a lot of snaps.
Yeah, we did. That was our goal going in. You know, as soon as the starters got the game under control, we're going to play the seniors next, and there's program guys that don't get to play a whole lot on Friday nights, but they've been with the program for 4 years. And to me, those guys are more special than the stars because, you know, it's easy for the stars to come out and play. They get recognized in the newspaper and they're starting. But the ones that don't get to play very much, they have a special place in our hearts because it's not easy to stay out there and not get a whole lot of playing time.
They get a lot of snaps at practice Monday through mm-hmm. Thursday. And like you said, that's not when the lights are shining. It's nice to get that notoriety on Friday night lights.
The bottom line is they understand their role on the football team.
Yes.
And everybody has a role, whether it's a scout team player or a special team player or starter. If everybody understands their role and accepts it, you know, then that brings together a football team. And that's what these seniors have done.
Exactly. When did the plan for Ethan Woodard hatch?
Well, we talked about it as a coaching staff on Wednesday, and I wanted to make sure it was okay with Ethan, and he said he would love to do it, and I don't think Dr. Fricks was too fired up about it, but we made sure that he wasn't going to get hit, and
right.
I thought that was a great honor for him.
Yes, and I've told many people this is one injury that seemed to affect you a lot, because of when it happened and the way it happened and the expectations that you had for him as well as other people. It seemed to really touch you this year.
Well, Ethan is a very good kid and a very good football player.
Yes.
And to, you know, tear his ACL in the first half of the first game, it was a heartbreaking situation.
Yes.
For the team and the staff. And but, you know, he's done well with it, and, you know, he's okay. He's rehabbing, and you know, the future, if he wants to continue to play football, is there for him. And if not, it's okay too. But he is a special kid.
Let's get to the Yellow Jacket game. 8 possessions in the first half, 7 touchdowns, and you ran out the clock. Second half comes along, you get 3 possessions, a touchdown. Since it was a running clock in the second half, we went for it on fourth down. We didn't make it, and then we ran out the clock. Pretty efficient pound and shoot offense, wouldn't you say?
Yeah, I think we had over 500 yards total offense. I think Kalen threw for 205, and we rushed for 330-something, I think. And, you know, other than, you know, I didn't think we played our best game up front, but, you know, it's hard on these kids.
Yeah.
We've had 3 games in a row where, we, you know, our opponents weren't that great, but we still got to go out and perform. And I know the kids and the coaching staff are excited about getting to the playoffs.
We started substituting with about 8 minutes left in the first half, 8 minutes left in the second quarter, so the starters didn't get a whole lot of playing time. The black shirt defense, the team comes out dressed in all black, and boy, the black shirt defense rose to the occasion, just shut this team out. If you look at the stats for this team, they had a total of 10 possessions, 7 punts, 2 turnovers, a TD, and according to my running stat sheet, which is not near as official as Coach Hobby's, I had them for 3 first downs the entire game, won the first half.
Yeah, I think that's what I saw too. I think they had 21 carries for 18 yards on rushing, and I did think they threw the ball, had over 100 yards passing. But, you know, I think Coach is doing a good job over there. I think they're much better than they were last year. I think they had a lot of players that didn't play last night because of injuries, so they were much better on tape than they were last night.
Yeah, he didn't have all of his bullets that he's used to carrying in the six-shooter there to come play this game. Yeah, I had you for around 300, or Cohen Marcus, our statistician, had you for around 385 yards in the first half. That's just a pretty dominating performance. It's 35-0 at the end of the first quarter, and you're real happy. We put the game in a book, I think, after the first touchdown drive, and you're getting young people ready to play, and you got a lot of youngsters in the game. And what I really enjoy watching is when we have those running clocks, and we're putting a lot of freshmen on the field, Coach, in key roles, and they're doing well.
Yeah, we're really high on our freshman class. We have a lot of them, and you know, they're not only good football players, but they're high character kids, and we're really excited about our freshman class. Of course, our sophomore class too, and our juniors. So we do feel good about the future.
19 rushing touchdowns for Aliko Dennis. When's the last time we had a running back score that many TDs?
I can't remember, but Aliko's really playing well. You know, I'm anxious to see, you know, he hadn't played a whole lot the last 3 weeks. You know, there's going to come a point in time where he's going to have to play a lot, and Bryson's going to have to play a lot. So, you know, it's time to get to the nitty-gritty, and, you know, we're excited about it.
Kalen Riley he threw his 19th touchdown pass last night. Our quarterbacks do really well, and he continues to do well. And his first rushing touchdown was a real nice one.
Yeah, Kalen continues to play at a high level, and that's what we need for him to do for us to make a run at this championship. So he's got to continue playing well. He's got to play smart. He can't throw interceptions. He can't fumble the ball. He's got to lead this offense in the proper way.
Robbie's Raiders are doing a job up front and makes everything possible that these rushers and passers are able to do. And as Coach said, we're going to be getting to the nitty-gritty, but we're going to get to the nitty-gritty of the first half. We'll come back with the highlights. You're watching the Coach Hal Lamb Show. Welcome back to the Coach Hal Lamb Show. Coach, rain threatening all day. It turned out to be a nice night, except for the guys playing the game, because it was humid, 80%+ humidity.
It was humid. Warm-ups was really, really humid. And then, you know, there were a lot of people changing their game. Some people changed their games to Thursday night. And, you know, we did. I looked at it Wednesday morning about 11 o'clock, looked at the weather, but I really didn't think it was necessary. And it turned out to be a good night.
Fourth and fifth grade chorus from Calhoun Elementary School performing the national anthem. And, Coach, they were loud. You can understand every word they said, a lot of energy. They set the tone for the night. They did a nice job.
Well, those are some of the things that we as players and coaches have to miss.
Yes.
So we don't get an opportunity to see it, but I'm sure they did a good job.
Somebody needs to record last week's trio. They were unbelievable. Captains for tonight's game with all the other seniors lined up, holding elbow to elbow on the sideline.
Got Drew McIntyre, Jack D. Ford, Ethan Woodard, and Jairo Wilson.
Ethan Woodard in number 11. It's nice to see, wasn't it? Sunday shoes, cap and gown, the whole town gathered around, waited 18 years, now it's all come down to this. How about that? Very nice.
That's a good sign.
It is good. They make good run-through banners. And here come the Yellow Jackets, dressed in all black.
The seniors weren't going to wait on the rest of the team. They were just going to run through the sign.
I think you're right. They're ready to go. And we're ready to kick off. And Coahulla Creek's going to kick to us. And they kicked this ball out of bounds on purpose.
Yeah, their kicking game hasn't been that strong. The punter was decent, but the kickoff guy was struggling a little bit.
Okay, first and 10. Since it didn't cross the 35, we get it at the 37 where it went out of bounds. New rule for me, and Aliko Dennis starts things off. At the top of the screen was Ethan Woodard staying out of the action.
Yep, we made sure he stayed out of the action, and
and then
Ethan, happy for him. That was a good night for him.
Bittersweet moment.
Yep.
I thought the referee even came over and said something to him.
Yep, he did.
and that was nice. Whitfield County Association of Referees are from. Did a pretty decent job. All righty, we're going to fake to Aliko. We're going to throw the ball down the field, and if it's just a smidge farther down the field, Jared Carden's got a TD.
Yeah, Jarrett's he's not quite 100%, but he's getting close. He made some catches last night that he felt better about.
Aliko, or Kalen, keeps it, and then he's off to the races. Cuts back to the left-hand side. He's across the 30, and he is off on a 53-yard jaunt. It's a touchdown, the seventh rushing touchdown of the season for Kalen Riley.
That was a good job on the zone read there by Kalen. When we run that play, it's always a read. Kalen can give it or pull it to based on what the defense does, and he made a good read there.
Coach, there's 11:43 left in the first quarter.
Yeah,
17 seconds.
That was a quick score.
Yes, it was. Alex Flores with the kick through the uprights. It's on its way to the shortstop. That's Jarrett Carden holding and Jacob Callahan snapping. We lead 7-0. And the onslaught begins. The seniors showing out on senior night as well as the rest of the team. Toe meets leather. And this is Alex Flores doing the kickoff.
Yeah, Alex has had to kick tonight. Juan has got some back issues, so we held him out. We're going to hold him out until probably Wednesday of next week, and he should be ready to go next Friday.
Coahulla Creek had no place to run, Coach. I mean, absolutely no place. And they may have had 100 yards of offense, but one of it came on a pass play in the second half.
Yeah.
I mean, half of it, 49-yard or something.
Well, we're glad to get Balin back in the lineup. We were skeptical on whether to play him.
Right.
Last night, but I tell you, Monday he came out to practice and he looked 100%, so we said, why not? He's 100%, let's go with it. And then Wednesday he catches a ball wrong and he's got a torn ligament in his thumb. He has to have a cast on it, he's good to go.
How much did you have to talk to your team about not blocking the punt, because we could have blocked several last night?
Oh, there was a couple come up to me and said, Coach, you're not touching me. I said, well, it's okay. We're not going to go block a punt.
That was a 7-yard punt.
Yeah.
The ball went 11 yards in the air and then bounced back towards the line of scrimmage. We set up shop at their 42. Out here to Jarrett Carden. Coach, looks pretty healthy. Looking juking and jiving.
Yeah, he's getting better. He's probably closer to 95% maybe after last night. We'll get our two-back set in.
I like this set.
Yep.
Give the Bryson Bushong a little confusion in the backfield, but he straightens that out real quick. The free safety comes up and makes a hit. They've got a couple guys, particularly skill guys, run the ball well on kickoff returns and play hard in the secondary.
Yeah, I think they do play hard. You got to give coach credit there.
Yeah. And Aliko Dennis goes untouched to the end zone, folks. That's a 21-yard touchdown run. That is Aliko's 18th rushing touchdown of the season. Robbie's Raiders, Jack DeFore, Blake Garland, William Long, Drew McIntyre, Austin Stout. That's left to right from tackle to tackle with your tight ends of Landon Rice and Jairo Wilson. Coach, he's not getting touched.
Yeah, that was a great block by Bryson Bushong on the corner, too. We had our two backs in there. And when both of them in there, the other one obviously has got to make a great block somewhere, and I thought Bryson did a good job there.
10:05 left, 14-0. Alex Flores with the extra point. Alex is still perfect on the season, Coach.
Yeah, Alex continues to do a good job kicking. He kicked that one in the end zone.
Yeah,
I asked him what got into him there. He just laughed.
Well, he kicked several touchbacks in pregame.
Mm-hmm.
Alex is 40-for-40 on the season, and once again, Coach, it's going to be difficult to pick out the initial hits. Quarterback rolls to the left. We got people in his face, and I think we were really looking for some fresh ribs. We might have been able to pick that off.
Yeah, Red Abernathy has really played well in the absence of Ethan. He's really come into his own.
He's grown quite a bit, hasn't he?
Yes, he has.
All righty, they're going to punt again. This young man gets high punts. Maybe not necessarily real long, but high punts. I like this return from our 40. Fakes right, goes left, gets a 7-yard return.
I think Ryan has done a really good job returning punts. He catches the ball when he's supposed to catch them most of the time, and he's a solid punt returner.
We set up at our 47-yard line, drop straight back, look downfield. Big boys open, Landon Rice, Thor thundering down the field. First and 10 for the Jackets. I think he thought he maybe dropped it.
Yeah, that was a good throw by Kalen.
Right on the money.
Right on the line, good route by Landon. There's Aliko again.
He got touched this time after a nice stiff arm, and he just walks through that arm tackle. Touchdown! 19th of the season for Mr. Two. The Deuce puts 6 on the board. Jacob Callahan will be snapping, Jarrett Carden holding. And we still have Alex in kicking. Thank goodness Gabriel Garcia wears different colored shoes, because
yeah.
The numbers tend to mesh together?
Well, we want them both of them kicking tonight just because they were seniors, and I think Gabriel, Gabriel's just as good as Alex. You know, he had a setback early in the season with the injury to his groin, and so, you know, they're both probably going to kick from here on out, but they're both doing a good job.
Yeah, like I said, sometimes the numbers crunch up. That's a good kickoff down to the 5-yard line. And there's good kick coverage.
Yep, got, 24-yard line?
Yes. Motion from right to left by the H-back. And we just stuff it up, Coach. My goodness, look at all the gold hats. Marcus Ambrosio's at center, or nose guard, rather.
Yeah, Marcos is a senior, and we gave him the start tonight, and he's doing a good job for us.
Well, they ran the tunnel screen. It's kind of like a kickoff return. When you go laterally against this black shirt defense, that's a mistake because pursuit catches you quick.
Yes, it does.
Real quick. Threatening a blitz on the right-hand side, back off. That's Baylen Spector cheating up there. Runner dips in, dips out, and they should have, when he dipped in, should have just kept going in.
That's great hustle on the backside by Jira. You know, we had a stunt off the weak side there, and he did a good job chasing it down.
Wing to the right. A lot of times they put their wing guy, their H-back, behind the guard, behind the tackle, between the guard and tackle, really trying to load up an area.
Yeah, I think the H-back is probably one of the better players, number two, one of the bigger players.
Harris, he does a good job. Nice fair catch.
That was a tough catch. That ball was knuckling. Good job by Ryan.
Yeah, he did a good job. We start first and 10 at our 41-yard line. There's 5:18 left in the first quarter, and we lead 21-0. I call it a little hitch, or a little stop route on the outside.
Yep. It's actually a corner route on top of it and a hitch under it, and Kalen makes a good read.
Kalen fakes the Bryson Bushong running a sweep. Kalen just runs through people and just powers his way to a significant gain.
I think Kalen had a good night rushing the football last night.
Yeah, his stats won't show up because of a couple sacks, but he had a good night rushing ball. You're right.
A little sloppy with the ball there. We got to be more aggressive with that read, but you know, he was able to get back on the ball.
Secure the ball. Three receivers right, one left, to the wide side up top of the screen. Fake to the running back. And this is a nice catch, Coach.
Great catch by Ryan. That's a good throw by Kalen, too. You know, only our guy could have caught that ball, and I thought it was a good throw and a good catch.
Nice back shoulder throw. I've seen you guys work on this in practice. Well done. Two back set. Give it to Mr. Bushong. The senior goes a la Herschel Walker, just shy of the end zone. A little different size and bodies. Mm-hmm. Let's give it to him again.
Let's run it again.
All right. Same play. There's your touchdown. Bryson Bushong takes it in, powers it into the end zone for his sixth rushing touchdown of the season. A little crisscross, a little cross buck action.
Yep.
Still run some wing tee plays out of this spread offense, can't we?
Yes, we can.
Jacob snapping, Jared holding.
I think this is Gabriel kicking, isn't it?
It is. Gold shoes.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, he came onto the field, and I looked up, and I was about ready to say Alex's name. And I said, whoa, we got the gold shoes on the field. This is Gabriel kicking. And Gabriel went perfect on the night. 3 for 3, I believe. He's up to 13 for 13 on the season. Get a body on this guy.
And number 7 is not a bad player, but and that was a good tackle by our kicker, Alex.
It was.
And we just, that wasn't a very good kickoff session there, I guess you'd call it.
This is a nice play by Red Abernathy. He could have gotten in there too early, showed nice poise, and then delivered the blow and knocked the pass loose. That could have been a pass interference call. Oh, my gosh. Count the hats. Made a dog pile right there at the line of scrimmage. They're going to give him a yard, put it at our 49.5. Two receivers left, one right. Quarterback keeps it. He wants to roll to the right-hand side, and he does as he rolls across the artificial turf. Seventh year for the turf.
Yeah, I think we recovered a fumble there.
Yes, we did.
I don't know who got that fumble.
Well, I thought it was Malik came up with it at the bottom, but I'm not real sure. Mm-hmm. I thought I saw him hand it to the referee. So we get us a turnover. I'm going to give credit to Malik until you correct me after you view the film. We've got a holding penalty here.
Yeah, this is there's about two or three plays in a row. We don't look very good here. We got a holding call, And then we have a, I think we have a sack here. Or
offsides then a sack.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, they start blitzing. They start getting aggressive with their defense. I think coaches realize, you know, what the hey? It's the 10th game of the season. Let's pin our ears back.
Nice. Yeah, I think we screwed up the protection there and never gave Kalen a chance.
No, he didn't. That guy came in pretty much untouched. They had some blitz coming from the outside and, as you said, messed up on the inside. Three receivers to the right. We're back at our 28-yard line. And
not very good there either.
No, not real good.
About three plays. Those are only really three bad plays we've had, but we'll get it corrected here the next play. Next play.
Yeah, real quick. We're at their 24-yard line. It's third and forever, folks. So when it's third and forever, let's run, a tunnel screen.
Yes, we will run our screen.
Yes. And we said with the pressure that was coming, you know, dump it off to somebody out here because it's going to be one-on-one.
Well, we feel good about our screen game, obviously. We work on it a tremendous amount, and that's great blocking downfield and obviously a great run by Malik.
It is a 76-yard touchdown run. The big boy, Austin Stout, downfield blocking. Did you see that?
He got down there.
Yes, he did. McNasty putting on him on a block downfield. I like that. I don't know why the referee from the secondary threw a flag. Did they ever tell you why they picked
it
up?
Yeah, it was a sideline warning on us. So the first one is just a warning. The second one's a 5-yard penalty.
So, yeah, I was saying on the radio, I said, this one's coming back. The referee threw the flag. It, as soon as the play snapped, I said, it might be a legal procedure. And they finally got to talking. And, hey, we got us a 76-yard touchdown run.
I think we had too many people in the white on the sideline when the play started.
35 to nothing with the way that they were scoring points. Maybe the referee ought to watch a game. Anyway, that's just my opinion. All right, here we go. 35 to nothing. Very little time left. And Alex puts toe to leather. Kicks it down to the 7-8 yard line, coach. Good hang time.
Yes.
And there's good coverage.
That's good coverage there. Again, about the 23-yard line. We can live with that.
That's what I wrote on the sheet. 23. First and 10. No place to go. Quarter's going to come to a close.
Glad to see number 4 back in the game for sure.
He is a heat-seeking, football-seeking tackler.
He's been out, open week and then 2 games, I think.
Yes. Yeah.
And it's really amazing that he came back as early as he did. You know, a high ankle sprain sometimes can just linger and linger and linger. But I tell you, he worked extremely hard to get healthy, and I'm glad he's back.
Nice play there, and there's a slobber knocker, and that is your middle linebacker.
And Balin. Good job by Christian East there.
Well, they finished him off, coach.
What a year Christian East has had.
Yes.
You know, there was a lot of people skeptical about Christian East coming into the season, but us as a coaching staff were not. We knew that he was a very good football player, and we knew that he would have a very good year.
Smack is letting his play talk for him.
Yep.
Yeah, there he goes. Nice job. Ooh, nice block. Good move. Gets outside, keeps his balance, gets it into the Colt territory.
Nice job by Ryan. And, you know, we're looking for, you know, we always say we're looking for a first down there.
He makes you, I mentioned it on the radio, he makes you real proud later on in return. Gets one exactly 10 yards.
Good job by Dustin there and Kalen on the little out route.
Yeah. Dusty's got dual roles on this team. He's managing the Washington Nationals and playing football. All righty. We're just running downfield, coach, running over people.
That was our power read play, and Kalen did a good job getting north and south.
Robbie's Raiders are doing a great job.
Yes, William
Long with the snap. Look at the time.
I thought this was a great read by Kalen.
I thought that was going to be 6.
We had something down the middle he was looking at that was cloudy, and he found his check down to Lico, and we just got to catch the ball there. Throw it to Jarrett for a first down.
Look at him, scooting out there. The Roadrunner, quick.
We'll get it down to the 15 or the 13.
First and 10 for the Jackets. Give it to the running back on the left-hand side. Puts his shoulder down. I heard the pads crack when he lowered his shoulder.
That was a good hard run by Lico. I like, you know, sometimes you just got to lower your shoulder and get some yards, and I thought he did a great job there.
He got five. Mm-hmm. Timeout by Coahulla Creek. Out of the timeout, here we come with second and five. Low snap. This was a touchdown to a senior.
Yeah, the snap, it wasn't terrible, but Kalen kind of bailed out before he caught it. He knows he's got to see the ball in his hands before he goes anywhere.
Tunnel screen, right-hand side. There we got. We didn't get Rhett Rogers on the first one, but we did get a senior on the second one.
Yeah, but he called a block in the back there. They called it on Drew McIntyre, and my guys up in the box said it was a bad call.
It was a horrible call, yeah. Coach. Horrible. It was not a block in the back. So we throw it out here to Ryan Randall, and he's going to get the real six that sticks on the board. So we did our best to get a couple seniors touchdowns.
Yes, we did.
We tried hard. Throw it over to the left-hand side, and Ryan Randall gets his second touchdown reception of the year. And that is the 19th touchdown pass of the season for Mr. Riley. And we're going to have Jacob snapping, Jarrett holding, and Gabriel kicking. You know, we got a lot of two JCs. J.C. snapping, J.C. holding, and G.G. kicking.
Mm-hmm.
Got a lot of alliteration with the consonants there.
We have another J.C. Fuller on the team.
Yes. And then we switch it around and go C.J. at nose guard. Keeps me confused. My tongue gets tied. All righty. Good coverage.
There we go.
This is
nice
what you want.
Nice kick, nice coverage.
Yeah, Bryson Davis, Rhett Rogers. You just got all kinds of guys around there. The second quarter comes here, and this young man runs the ball hard, 27. He got a lot of opportunities last night.
Yeah, we got some seniors in the game now. We got Tyler Higginbotham. This is his first year of football, and he's been a pleasant surprise for this football team. He's done well. He's has a great attitude. He's such a good kid.
You're going to love his tackle later in the game where the kid tries to duck him.
We got Jacob Robinson on the other side, who is one of the best kids on the football team. He's a special kid. He's going to do well in life, I promise you that.
He is a great kid.
Yep.
I love having him in class.
And then you got some Easton Trotters the same way at linebacker. You got Rhett Rogers at linebacker. And you got Connor Akridge. All three of those guys are seniors that they're program guys. They've done extremely well and know their role on the football team.
I said in the booth, I think we tipped that ball. If we didn't tip it, we really disrupted the receiver's vision.
Yep.
And they can't, no place to run. It's going to bring up a punting situation again.
You also got Jonah Landry in there, who does a lot for this football team. He may be the most versatile player on the team with the wide receiver, outside linebacker, punter. He does a lot for us.
On special teams?
Yes, on special teams, on the kickoff team, does a lot.
Coach, this is a nice catch with a guy standing right in your face. You know how hard that is to
do. Oh, yes.
You're back there catching punts. You are on an island. Three receivers left. We got new offense.
Yeah, we got Brett Potts in the game there and at quarterback, and we screwed the blocking up out here on the perimeter. That wasn't good, but we got Jess Ralston in the game. And
oh, my. For the second Friday in a row, he's across midfield. He's down the sideline, and sunshine, Jess Ralston takes it to the house. 67 yards after a 66-yarder last week.
His yards per carry is pretty good, I bet.
They're phenomenal. It's just unbelievable after this game.
Up front, I think we had Thomas Ross, Hunter Dunlap in the game. At guards, they're seniors. Cade Walker was in the game, a junior. J.C. Fuller was snapping, and Christian Paul was the other tackle, who's a junior.
Well, snap was high, went through the holder's hands, picks it up, and tries to squeeze it into the end zone and just can't quite get there. Pursuit catches him. So we're going to stay at 48 with 4:21 left in the first half. I noticed Coahulla Creek started slowing down their running their plays. They're using a 25-second clock more. This is a nice kick.
Nice kick. I really couldn't tell what happened on that extra point. I was blocked. I couldn't see the ball.
It was just a high snap. Okay. And we just called a high snap to say we didn't secure it well enough. It fell to the ground. All right, running back goes to the left-hand side after nice kick coverage, and boy, the youngins are in there, aren't they?
Yep, General Landry, Connor Akridge on the tackle. Really got the same group that I talked about a while ago.
Yes.
We're letting them play a good bit.
Little swing pass out to the running back, and looks like he gets a bunch of yards, but we We'd back him up quite a bit. He gains 5 or 6 yards and makes it a long ways to go, and then we're going to stick him right here. 27 runs hard for them.
Yes, he does. He ran the ball very well.
Upright runner, but he puts his shoulder down and keeps the legs churning. Going to force a punting situation again for the Colts. This is his best punt of the night.
Well, he booted a couple of them. Is this the one he really got a hold to?
Rolled quite a bit, yeah. This one, nice spiral and turned over. Yeah. This is a beautiful punt. Nose turns down, kicks it to the right of us.
And I thought Tyler Putnam did a pretty good job here.
I liked him picking this punt up,
yes,
Coach.
Yes, I did too. If he doesn't pick it up, it's probably going inside the 5.
That's what I'm thinking. He picks it up at the 16. It's a 54-yard punt, but he saves us a lot of field position. The young pound-and-shoot offense is in there. They're coming with a lot of blitzes right now, which...
That's Jakeenan Dixon. We're glad to get him back in the lineup. He's been hurt.
Yeah. They slow us down there. We're going to get an illegal procedure against the Yellow Jackets. Back us up to the 18. I like Coahulla Creek's attitude.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, they're just playing hard right now.
Yeah, I think Coach is doing a good job up there. I really don't know his background, where he came from, but he was really, really beat down this time last year when I talked to him, but he was more upbeat this year.
Did a lot of coaching in Tennessee.
Mm, gotcha.
Yeah. Half comes to a close, and we're up 48-0. The halftime adjustments are to make sure we got everybody lined up so they can get into the game. When did you find out you had a running clock in the third quarter?
When we get back out to the field, but I just,
assumed.
I assumed going in we were.
It was the 10th game of the season,
and
we're up 48-0. We said the same thing on the radio, that it's probably going to be a running clock in the entire second half. It is senior night. Sit back in that Barca lounger, grab you a Daddy-O's donut. You're going to see the best doggone band in the land, the Pride of Georgia's Northland. 284 marching strong, led by director Michael Clark, assisted by Larry Brown, and led on the field by drum major Sarah Green. You're watching the Coach Hallam Show.
Presenting the Calhoun High School Marching Yellow Jackets under the field direction of Miss Sarah Green. Tonight the band will be performing their senior show and dedicating the show to the seniors. They are Nayeli Aguano, Dave Berrio, Zane Fox, Danielle Bramlett, Caitlin Carroll, Malia Carter, Megan Casper, Kayla Chapman, Austin Cherry, Kirsten Coberson, Kevin Dinn, Hannah Dogger, Sandy Estrada, Emma Evans, Colin Farrell, Colin Faulkner, Shelby Freeman, Josh Gallman, Elizabeth Garcia, Molly Gilroy, Ray Gonzalez, Melissa Greason, Hannah Gregory, Emmanuel
Hirschfeld,
Nick Harper, Caleb Hayes, Rebecca Hyde, Maddie Halbert, Taylor Hudson, Mary Elizabeth Huff, Olivia Hull, Chandler Paget, Lily Prater, Matthew Proctor, Josh Reddick, Megan Sanford, Gabe Smith, Kyle Smith, Taylor Stanley, Sam Tao, Hunter Walker, Alyssa Waters, and Ms. Janelle Williams. Thank you, seniors.
back to press box.
Welcome back to the Coach Hal Am Show. We're ready for the second half. As you said, you found out when we walked out onto the field for the second half that we are going to have a running clock, so we're going to get a lot of guys in quick.
Yes, you know, we talked about the same group that left the field in the first half was going on back on the field, but we were going to quickly sub. But we got our JV special teams in.
Yes. Toe meets leather. We kicked the ball down to the 16, he drops it, picks it up at the 11, and he finds a little bit of a hole, gets to the 20, and that's it, folks. Yeah, this is your JV smack team.
Good job there by our JV smack team. Good kick.
Yeah, it was nice and high. Oh, my golly. There was the play. The kid tried to duck under B-Rock. B-Rock just reached around with his long arms and grabbed him, threw him to the deck. It was funny. All right, roll out the left-hand side. I'm sure Coahulla Creek's like a lot of other teams. They hear footsteps.
Oh, yeah.
Ear holes in the back of the helmet. Quarterback fakes a running play, runs a little screen out here on the left-hand side.
That was a good pressure by B-Rock on the quarterback.
They get positive gain out of that.
The only other one I really didn't mention is earlier was Jamie Riddle. Reynolds is in at corner there.
Yes.
And Herschel would have been playing too, but Herschel was hurt.
Really?
He got hurt last week, so he was not available.
Yeah, now that you mention it, I didn't see 25 on the field. The kicker plays shortstop, kicks it away from us, and it rolls around and comes to a stop at our 31-yard line where we'll put it in play.
Yeah, I thought Tyler probably should have caught that one, and I told him that. I said, we just got to catch that ball, Tyler. But he's just a young one.
Yeah.
And we have a personal foul there to back us up.
That was at the very end of that play.
Yeah, I'll have to go back and look at that. I think it was, I don't know who it was.
Yeah, they threw it from like midfield or our 40 and landed on our 41 or 36 or something like that. Anyway, we started first and 10 from our 16. Then we get an illegal procedure, and that's first and 15 from the 11. And that's not going to take us long to make it up, though.
There's Gage Giddens.
Coach, he is
10th grader.
Smooth,
yes,
fast,
he is. Yep.
Quick feet.
He's going to be a really, really good player for us the next 2 years.
I think you're right, Coach. I'd back that bet. Two set.
There's Keenan. Keenan Dixon.
And Keenan makes a couple nice cuts here.
Yes, he does.
And I like how he gets north-south.
Mm-hmm.
Two receivers right, two, one left.
We run a counter here, which is a guard tackle pull. And there goes Gage again. And they call holding there on Jordan Baldridge, number 28, which I didn't think was a holding.
I know. Yeah, that was a nice gain. It wiped out a big run. It was around a 50-yard run, which would have really helped his average. But we're going to end up after the holding with second and three or four.
Mm-hmm.
Two receivers right and two left.
Throw a screen out here to Tyler. I don't really know what happened to that. I thought it was thrown behind him just a little bit.
It was. We'll say it was a wet ball.
This was a great run by Gage getting the first down because it was third and about three. And he keeps moving his feet and gets the first down.
They thought they had a stop. Mm-hmm. And he ends up making a big gain. To our 45-yard line, first and 10, Gage Giddens just showing the weight room
is
strength.
This is a good run by Jakina.
Yeah, watch him square your shoulder. Look at those cuts.
Good vision there. We just got to get a little faster there, Jakina.
He felt the elephant on his back there around the 15-yard line. Great cuts.
Well, he really hadn't had a whole lot of work in probably about 4 or 5 weeks, to be
exactly.
honest.
Yeah.
And we messed that blocking up there.
They tackle us back at our 13.
And we got some new kids in there on the O-line. You got Ryan Thatcher in there at right tackle. Good job on the screen there. Is that Porter? Porter Law for a touchdown?
Yes, it is.
Good execution on the screen. You had Ryan Thatcher. I think you had Andrew Clements at left tackle. And I think the guards, the centers was the same.
That was Gavin Gray making that pass.
Yeah, Gavin is a freshman. He's going to be a really good player for us as well.
His second touchdown pass of the year, Porter's second touchdown reception. Toe meets leather. This is a nice kick, Coach. I like this. Gabriel gets a touchback. I think that's his second touchback of the season.
Let's see who we got in the game here now. There's Owen Williams making a big hit.
He's
a 10th grader.
Slobber knocker.
Really good one for us. We got Brantley Nation at linebacker, a junior.
We're going to call his name
number
later.
Number 88. Pressure on the quarterback. That is Peyton Morrow out here making a tackle, along with Brandon Spector, number 27, both freshmen.
Peyton's pretty quick. You're going to see
that
on the run.
Oh, he's real quick.
Bad exchange, and we're going to get
there's Brantley Nation getting a fumble recovery.
Yeah, he picks up another turnover.
You got Bailey Lester in the game also, Zach McKenzie in the game. Zach's a junior, Bailey's a sophomore. There goes Zach Fuller, who's a freshman at running back.
Watch him keep his legs rolling. The Pistons are churning, folks.
55, Drew Johnson. 51 is Jacob Haynes up front. We got a tight end in the game. We got Beck Fletcher in there at tight end. Good read by Gavin on the zone read. Canyon Turner's in at right guard, sophomore.
Third quarter comes to close, and that was a big, big hole on the right-hand side. And as you said, excellent read by Gavin. Yeah, they stuff us at the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, they beat us up there.
Yeah.
Well, they had too many in the box. Right tackle, you got Matthew Ralston, who's a 10th grader.
The Colts are still playing hard, coming with some blitzes.
Yep.
They know we're going to run, and they're stuffing it.
Third and goal here.
From the 11.
We throw the screen here. I think we got a touchdown if Brandon just stays inside. I don't know what. That one kid makes him go outside. If he stays up inside, he'll score.
Steps out of bounds. They spot it at the 6 where it's going to be fourth and goal. We're going to roll to the left-hand side. Tried to hit the guy in the back of the end zone. Coach, how hard is it to roll left and then stop and throw back right?
Yeah, well, that wasn't the way the play was designed, obviously. But
yes.
He was trying to hit Braylon Barton in the back of the end zone.
They run the ball to the right-hand side. They're in poor field position. They start off at their own six-yard line. We're in the fourth quarter. But they're going to put together a nice drive.
Yeah.
They get a nice pass here. Find their H-back, number two, eventually.
Oh, yeah, they run a little corner route on us.
Yeah.
I wonder where he came from. And yeah. we're in cover three, and I think the corner bit up on the underneath route.
Yeah, exactly. So they're going to have it at our 41, and that gets them a lot of stats, makes the stat sheet look a little bit better. Quarterback rolls to the right-hand side. Those out here, it's incomplete. We intercept the ball, but we're well out of bounds. Got a funny throwing motion.
Yeah, he does.
I started calling him Kent Tekalvi because it was such a sidearm motion. Quarterback rolls to the right, throws it downfield, looking for the guy down there. And that's a nice catch by that
nice
wide
catch.
Receiver.
Brandon would like to have that play back. He didn't play that very well, but it's a good learning lesson.
There you go. Nothing like Friday Night Lights. 27 bangs it in there. We hit him hard, keeps his feet going, gets it inside the five.
We got Zeke Nance in there, defensive end, a sophomore. We're really high on him. We think he's really going to be a good player.
Coach, he's going to fill out.
Yep. We got Jacob Haynes in there. Still got Beck Fletcher at linebacker. I think you got Axel Alizano at nose.
Yes.
Good stop by, is that Bailey? That's a big hit by Bailey, I think.
Yeah, I think it is.
And we got them fourth down here.
Yeah, we're making them work for this.
Fourth down, they hit the little stick route in there. Just got us.
Yeah.
Sometimes you got to say good job, offense.
Well done. Yeah, nice design play. They hit their H-back, Mr. Davis. High snap, get it up. I thought we were going to block it when that high snap came in. We gave it the college try, 55-7. I know Coach Hobb, the elder, really wanted that shutout. But it was nice for the Colts.
Yeah, it was. Save me a little money on the donuts.
Yes, it does. All right, to the right-hand side. Nice opening. Good kickoff return.
That's Peyton Morrow. Little Peyton.
He's quick, Coach. He's in the quarterback right now.
He gives the ball to Drew Rutledge. We got too many people in the backfield there.
Yeah.
I think we got Matthew Tulamondo at center, if I'm not mistaken.
We flinched on that. They jumped off sides, yeah. And they called off sides on them. So it's 5 yards against the Colts. We'll take it. We're trying to run the clock out here, Coach, which we will succeed. There's yeah. Rutledge.
Mm-hmm. Drew Rutledge, going to be a fine player. He's a freshman.
Got a wide receiver number.
Mm-hmm.
Give the ball to Mr. Rutledge again.
No. Peyton's taking off for this one.
Yeah, that's right. Good play fake.
Mm-hmm.
I told you he's quick.
Yep. We got Mario Coria in there, number 71, 10th grader.
He's a good kid, Coach.
Yeah, he's a great kid.
Yeah. I know his older brother. Good family. There's a nice little move. Outside, down the sideline, Mr. Morrow goes. They finally catch up with him, but not till he gets down around the 6 or 7 yard line. Spotted at the 7, first and goal. Shed a couple tackles, and that's going to run the clock out. And you guys are standing on the sideline going, no, don't
yeah.
do anything
yeah.
else.
We didn't want to score there.
Yeah.
But you had James Prater in there at running back on that last play. We got a lot of young kids in the game.
And when you're dressing 95, 97 kids for a home game, it makes it tough to get them all.
Yeah, it is. It's hard to get them all in. And our concentration last night was seniors.
Yes.
We want to make sure they got plenty of playing time and then roll with the rest of them. But a great group of kids, young kids that are coming up, we're excited about.
Exactly. The pipeline is full. We're going to take a timeout, and we're going to come back, and we're going to look at the stingers, the plays of the game. You're watching the Coach Hal Lamb Show. Welcome back to the Coach Hal Lamb Show. And, Coach, we're going to take a look at the stingers, the plays of the game. And we have four or five real nice ones. And the first one starts off with?
This is Kalen's touchdown run, I believe.
Yes. Nice play fake to Aliko. They bite. Kalen's through the line. Nice, easy cut to the left, and then he outruns the defense. Takes it to the house.
Yeah, he shows a good burst there.
Yeah, he
does. Really does.
Yeah, he does have a good burst.
Mm-hmm. I think this is the big hit by Christian and Balin on the speed sweep.
Oh.
Nice job right there by both those guys.
47-4, Land of Wood. Right now, the Colts are looking for the name of that train that just came through town.
And we got the touchdown pass from Gavin Gray to Porter Law on the screen. It was a great job blocking the perimeter out there by the wide out. I couldn't tell who it was.
Great timing.
Mm-hmm. Good timing.
Porter came around the blocks, the pass is there, and he takes it to the house. Second touchdown pass and reception from each fella. Ooh, 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 ooh. We got a fumble recovery.
There's Brantley Nation with the fumble recovery, BG.
On the ball. And so those are your stingers, your plays of the game. And it, as we mentioned, it was senior night. We honored the cheerleaders, the band, the football players, and I believe we're going to take a look at the everybody coming through the helmet. We're not going to see all the band members because there's many, many band mm-hmm. members. So we'll just give a shout out to the best doggone band in the land. And here come the cheerleaders, and leading things off is Bailey Barkham. And next is Hannah Gravett. Shelby Haggard. Georgia House. Reed McCracken. That is Alyssa Meadows. And the last of our seniors is Laney Stokes. And the football guys.
This is Connor Akridge, a senior linebacker, special team player. Then we got Marcos Ambrosio. There's Tony Hernandez, his brother.
Is that
Courtney? Yep.
I wondered who that was.
Yep.
Touchdown, Tony.
Tony was a good player for us on the 2011 state championship team. Nose guard.
And
Marcos is a nose guard. There's Blaine Anderson, who's a defensive end, offensive lineman for us. Trying really hard to get him to the next level.
Dad have any quarters left? Looks like he can play offensive line for us.
And Dusty Baker, he's a lot of positions, outside linebacker, wide receiver, special team player, very versatile. Bryson Bushon, he's obviously a running back and a special team player for us, does a good job for us.
Mom sits right below us.
Jarrett Carden, who is a wide receiver, probably just a wide receiver and a holder now, that he had played some defense until he got injured. Jack D4. Offensive lineman, defensive lineman, obviously going to Ole Miss on a football scholarship.
Down at the Grove.
Mm-hmm.
Georgia missed out on him.
Yep. And that's Hunter Dunlap, my senior offensive lineman.
I taught Hunter in fifth grade.
Mm. Hunter's had a good year. He's a great kid. He didn't really say a whole lot, doesn't cause any problems.
Great parents.
Yep. And then we got Christian East, middle linebacker. He's having a tremendous, tremendous year.
Stepped into some big shoes and filled them quite well.
Yep, he's making a lot of tackles for us.
Yes, he is. He and Jira leading tacklers on the team.
Noah Ferguson, same thing. He's a program guy. He was a special team player and a backup last year. But really, really playing well for us this year.
Yeah, doing a nice job.
I think this is Alex Flores, our kicker. He's been with us for 4 years. Really quiet kid, but he really does a good job kicking the football.
Got a great smile, Coach.
Yes, he does.
Yeah.
Gabriel Garcia, we got him out a couple of years ago. I think we saw him punting and kicking in PE class and talked him into. He's a really good soccer player.
Yes, he is.
Both he and Alex, so we're glad to get those guys on our team. Blake Garland, who is, you're talking about a program guy. As a ninth grader, I wouldn't have never thought he would have played for us as a starter, but he's starting for us at left guard because he gives tremendous effort.
Good technician.
Yep.
And particularly the size of kid he is.
Yes, he is.
Smallest guy on the line.
Mm-hmm.
But, folks, he is a solid 200 pounds.
Yep. Tyler Higginbotham came out this year to help us out, and I think it's been good for him. He's a part of this football team, and he's having a good time with it.
I think Coach Vince will be happy he played football.
Mm-hmm. You got Jonah Landry, very versatile player on our team, punter, outside linebacker, special team player, wide receiver. His brother was a good player for us, Matt Landry.
Mm-hmm.
And you got Drew McIntyre, offensive lineman, defensive lineman. Very strong, very good player. Got some offers at Air Force and Army.
Smart kid.
To go play football, so he's going to have an opportunity to go somewhere for sure.
His life is going to get better.
Yes. Herschel Patel, a program guy, a tremendous kid on this football team. He understands his role. He does exactly what we ask him to do, and unfortunately, he's hurt right now. Hopefully, we'll get him back next week, though.
Quiet young man, but a lot of intensity.
Yes. And we got Jamie Reynolds, a high-character kid that, yes sir, no sir, does what he's supposed to do, and his parents have really done a good job with him because he's a great, great person.
Big dog underneath that jersey. Got a lot of heart.
Mm-hmm. Colby Reynolds, he's a really, really good football player. He's going to have an opportunity to go to the next level, I hope. His mom has really, really done a good job with him, his parents, and he's a great kid. That's his little brother holding, yep.
The healthier he gets, the just more outstanding plays he makes.
Landon Rice, been with us for 2 years, hired his dad as a coach a couple of years ago, and Landon has been a big piece of the puzzle. He's a really, really good player, but he's even a better kid going to Auburn. To play
early.
Football. Yep, he's graduating early, going to be there in January. Be a good steal for Auburn.
And you can tell by talking with him, then you talk to his dad, you know why he's the way he is.
Kalen Riley, and a whole lot more you can say about Kalen. He's a special kid and a special player, and he's going to Mercer University to play football, and he's had an unbelievable career, not only in football, but his whole basketball, you name it. He's just a special player and a special kid.
Your brother's going to be happy.
Yes, he is.
Yeah.
Jacob Robinson, one of the best kids on the football team, a tremendous character. Yes sir, no sir kid, doesn't cause any problems either. He knows his role on the football team, and that's basically to be a leader, and he's really, really done a good job.
Works really hard at practice and sets the tone for this team.
Rhett Rogers has been a pleasant surprise. He's playing a lot at wide receiver for us, and he's playing some linebacker and special team guy. But he's really coming into his own this year, and he's a real physical kid, and he's done a good job for us.
You can see his confidence grow each week.
Thomas Ross, he's another program guy, been with us this whole time. He's a backup offensive lineman. He's been hurt. He's missed the last three or four, five weeks with a shoulder injury. But he's a great kid as well.
Yeah, he works hard. I remember him when he was in seventh grade.
Austin Stout has probably made the biggest turnaround of any kid on our football team. He didn't play as a ninth grader, came back out as a 10th grader. Got his life turned around, and he's really, really a tremendous kid. And working really hard to get him at the next level.
He's just happy to be here.
Yep. Jordan Tao, he's a program guy as well. Same thing. He played a lot of special teams as a backup to Will Connolly and those guys last year, but this year he probably improved more than anybody in the offseason, anybody on the football team.
He's showing out this year.
Easton Trotter, another great kid on this football team. Very physical kid. Special team guy, linebacker, just does what he's supposed to do, and he does it to the best of his ability. Ain't a whole lot more you can say about Jair Wilson either. We're gonna miss this guy. I promise you that. He's our leader vocally. He practices hard. He's a high character kid. He's what you want in a young man. That's for sure. And he's going to Wofford College on a football scholarship, and great parents as well.
Exactly.
And last is Ethan Woodard, a tremendous kid, tremendous player. Just hate that he missed his whole senior year, but he'll have a bright future just because of what kind of kid he is.
Yeah, he's handled this injury really, really well. I've never seen him down.
No.
He's been upbeat constantly.
He's a good kid.
Yeah, good kid. 29 of them, Coach. I mean, wow. I mean, when you started back in 1999, I think you and I had talked one time, I'd like to have at least, right around 20 seniors graduating, 20, 24 seniors graduating. And you're getting that every year because that provides your continuity, the staying power of the program.
Yeah, when we first got here, the numbers weren't that great. And, our goal at that time was to have 20 per class, which would give you 80 on the team. And lo and behold, it's a lot more than that. But, 29 is obviously the largest, probably the largest class we've had. We usually have anywhere from 20 to 26 maybe, somewhere in that range. But these 29 are very special, and the majority of them have been with us for 4 years, and they're a tremendous class. And we want to obviously finish this year off with a bang, but when it's all said and done, we're going to miss those guys.
Yes. Speaking of finishing the year off with a bang, the playoff picture is becoming clearer, and we are going to be hosting.
We will be playing the West Hall Spartans. Out of Gainesville. Actually, they won that region last year, and they will be the 4 seed this year. They've won their last 3 games to be the 4 seed, so they're playing really well right now. So we'll have to take a look at them and see what they got and go from there. But fortunately for us, we'll be at Phil Reeve Stadium, and our kids will be ready to go.
Third season is about to begin, the third segment of what you call the third season. I am, obviously we're optimistic, as are you. I just get the feeling the kids just wanted these last 3 games to get done. Let's get to the playoffs. I really notice a lot of energy out of the guys.
Well, our preparation and all that's got to change now. We've got to turn the page. Regular season's over, and to win a state championship, you've got to have 5 great weeks of preparation. You've got to have you got to practice better. You got to do the things you're supposed to do off the field. You don't do crazy stuff to have freak accidents. We've got to have everybody healthy, and this is the fun time of year, and that's what I told them last night. This is why you play, to get in the playoffs and make a run in the state championship, and it starts next week.
These seniors would like to leave a little niche on their resume, being back-to-back state champions.
Yeah, that would be a bonus for those guys. Obviously we haven't had a back-to-back state championship, so we have an opportunity, but we still got to go out and play. We still got to execute, and we got to be mentally ready to play. We got to do the things that they know what it takes to win a state championship. They won it last year, so they've got to do all those things again, and we've got to get a few breaks here and there. We've got to get some luck because that's part of it.
Yes, it is.
We need to be focused and ready to go.
Luck is when great preparation meets an opportunity.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
And there you go. If you'd like to watch this game again, you'd like to watch the seniors walk across the field, you can do it any number of times that you want by going to CalhounTDClub.com. You can watch a replay. That's CalhounTDClub.com. Thanks again to Coach Bill Long's video broadcasting class, to producer Phoebe Jude, and to director Louis Reyes. They bring the boys of fall to you any number of times you want. Any final comments?
No, that's it.
That's it. Congratulations again on another 10-0 season. You've been watching the Coach Hal Lamb Show.
Producer.
absolute opportunity.